Hello, in this video we're going to talk about proof sequences. So on the left hand side of the screen we have an example from Hunter 2017, and on the right hand side of the screen we have tables 1.3 and 1.4, also from Hunter 2017. So the idea with these proof sequences is the following. We ask ourselves, what is the reason that line 4 is true? How can we obtain Q from the previous lines? Okay, so up above in lines 1, 2, and 3, we're given P. We're given that that's true. In line 2, we're given if P, then Q. That's given as true. And in line 3, we're given if Q, then R. So we have to piece those together. It's kind of like a puzzle. You know, how could you combine those statements to then result in Q? And the ways we can combine things are listed in these tables. So before we post the answer for line 4, I'd like to highlight something called modus ponens. That turns out to be very important for this particular problem. So modus ponens is right here in table 1.4. And to consider an example, let's look at the following. Modus ponens works like this. It says if you've got P, that's like the hypothesis, and then you also have if P then Q, right? If you have P and you have P then Q, then the result is that you know Q is true. Here's a real world example. Suppose somebody tells you that the plane is delayed 2 hours, and then they also tell you that if the plane is delayed 2 hours, then you will miss your connecting flight. Well, the conclusion is Q. Therefore, you will miss your connecting flight. Okay, so that's the idea. If you got P and you have P then Q, the result is that Q must be true. And that's exactly what we have in lines 1 and 2. That implies that Q must be true. So let's put that in right here. So this is modus ponens. And I'm also going to make a note here that this is by 1 and 2, just so we know, you know, what lines we're using in the modus ponens inference. Okay, so let me clear some space. Now let's look at line 5. How can we come up with R given all of these lines 1, 2, 3, and 4? Why is R true? Well, this is another application of modus ponens. Okay, so we've got Q. So let me put that down here. We've got Q. We've already established Q is true. We did that on line 4. And what else do we know? We know that Q implies R is true because that was given. Okay, so we have these two pieces of information. And again, this is modus ponens. I know that there's different letters, but the letters, we don't care if it's an apple and a banana. All we care about is, like, we know that the hypothesis is true, right? We know Q is true. And we also have this if-then statement. If Q is true, then we get R. Well, therefore, R is true, again, by modus ponens. And I'm going to put a note here, modus ponens. Now, in this case, we used line 4. That was the hypothesis. We knew that was true. And we also had the if-then statement sitting up here on line 3. So it's helpful to put what lines you used in concluding the result.